When your project is first created in Bitbucket, you are given an empty repository. Click on I'm starting from scratch to view a list of commands you need to run in order to create an area on your hard drive for this project. Create a folder for your project somewhere on your hard drive. On Windows, you will need to open Git Bash in this directory. You might be able to do this through the right-click menu. If Git Bash is not an option in your right-click menu, then you will need to navigate to the folder in Git Bash. Use the cd command, and instead of typing c colon for your hard drive, you type slash c slash, and then the rest of the directory. Once you are in the appropriate directory in Git Bash, you will use the git init command. After using git init, you will use the git remote command provided to you from Bitbucket, which includes the URL of your repository. Now you are ready to add files to your project. Create a new text file and enter some text. When you go back to the Git Bash window, type git status. It will show you that there are changes waiting to be committed. Next, type git add and then the name of your file. This adds the file to the current commit. You can add as many files as you would like to a commit. After you use the git add command, type git commit. If you get a vim window and you don't know how to use vim, type colon, then q, then enter, and it will exit. It might open a different text editor. You can change the commit message within the editor and then save and quit, and your commit will be ready to go. As a shortcut, or if you want to avoid vim for now, you can type git commit dash m and then a commit message. Once you've made all the commits you want to, you will push all of the commits to the repository server. Use git push dash u origin master to push your commits to the server on the master branch. We aren't going to worry about branching right now, so it's just best to memorize the push command. After you push your changes, you'll be able to see the files and the commits on the web interface of Bitbucket. With GitHub, if you selected Initialize with README when creating the repository, you will already have one item committed to the repo automatically. Locate your repository's URL on your repository page. Open Git Bash in the folder you wish to store your project. Instead of using git init and git remote, we will instead use git clone. Type git clone, and then paste the URL of your repository. You will see the README file is now on your hard drive. You can also add a new file and commit it just like we did when reviewing Bitbucket. Git add and then a file name will let you add a file to your current commit. You will use git add anytime you add a new file that you want to track, or if you have changed a file since the last time it was committed. Git remove and then a file name will let you remove a file from the repository, such as a deprecated file that is no longer in use. This will also remove it off your hard drive. Git status lets you view what files have been changed and/or added to the commit. Git commit dash m and then a message lets you commit your changes. Commits aren't automatically pushed to the server, you will need to do that manually. You can commit as much as you want before pushing, and you should generally commit once you've completed a task. Git push dash u origin master pushes your commits to the repository. Once you've made at least one commit, you can then push those changes to the repository. Then your files and the commits will show up on the repository website. Git pull allows you to pull any new changes from the repository onto your machine. If you have changed a file that has also been changed by somebody else, it will also attempt to automatically merge the changes. Now, let's go over what to do in case Git is unable to automatically merge changes. I am going to create a file and add it to the repository, and then I'm going to make some changes to that file elsewhere. Okay, now say that I don't know that the changes have been made to this file yet, and I'm going to update it again. I can add this file and commit it as normal, but when I go to push, Git stops me and tells me that I need to pull the latest updates. So now I try to pull, and get the message that the automatic merge failed. If I open the file that has the failed merge, it has been updated to show both my changes and the other person's changes, and it's up to me to manually fix the merge issue by choosing which code stays and which code gets thrown out. On the website, I can look at the diff, or the changes made between commits. I can also open up this file in any commit that it exists in, and see different versions of it. Once I've decided what is correct, I manually edit the file and save it. Then I add and commit this file again, and then I am able to push it to the repository. Thank you.